My name's Pat McKeever, I'm from Long Meadow Cider. We've been growing apples for over 50 years, and 4 years ago we decided to make our own apple cider. At the moment we have four ranges on our product. We have our medium, blossom burst, and we have an oak age, and then one recently that we released there is our rhubarb and honey. Well, we first started off on our home, get it established in Northern Ireland, which is doing very well now. Then we started over into France. We've got a bit of it into Rome and Switzerland and even as far as Mexico. We look at different markets to see, is cider good for that country? What will we look at? What is their taste? Are they sweet? Are they dry? Some countries prefer, you know, like a dry wine, so do we send out a dry cider to it? Which that helps in France, parts of the place where we have our cider in. It's our medium that goes out very well there. They like the dryness. Buyers would come over from different countries. We would go and meet them. Some of them would even come out to the farm, see the place, see the orchards and the apples and all, and see that it is done on the home farm. We done BBC Good Food Show in Birmingham last year, and which we're going to do it this year again. We got a bit of good follow-up from it last year, so we hoped this year to go. We have now got a client over there, a distributor, so we're going to go over there now and try and see if we can get into more places. You meet a lot of people at it, like, you know, you get cards, you get emails. When we come home, we chase them up. We got a few orders last year through Scotland and all of it, which was very good. We're trying to emphasise this year to try and get maybe some suppliers in the centre of London, like, you know, good restaurants, good hotels. That's what we're trying to aim for that high-end market. Solex was very good for us, like, when we started out. You were able to attend shows. Some of the stalls are very expensive, like, and you're getting money towards that, and you get money towards your travel allowance and all, which is very good, because if you go over and, like, you maybe only get one client, like, you know, it helps to pay them a few items and cuts down costs. When you see that Solex can pay for maybe 40% or so of that stall, which is very, it encourages you to do it. We'd like to try the States next year. We'd like to try and get something there, hopefully next year, and see how it goes there, because they really do like the Irish products out there. So it has took us maybe 4 years, you know, to build our product up before we could hit the next end place. So we hope to maybe aim to do something like there this year. My three tips are to look at the country, see is there cider there, or is there a market there for the cider. Go through your local and best NI, talk to your agent there, and see what they can help you with. And if you have a good product, push it. Now, there will be plenty of knocks on the way, you'll not get them all, but, like, all you need is two or three, and if you get a couple a year, happy days. It's great to see your product going into our countries. Many night there you get pictures sent through Twitter, like, you know, people drinking your cider at a skiing slope or so, like, you know, which is great. Like, you know, you never thought you would have had your own product, your own brand somewhere else in the world.